course. I know it's not going to be the sandwich chips, but I want these sandwich chips to be the sandwich chips. The hot dog chips.
I understand your desire for the hot dog chips. I don't know why those were so damn good.
I don't know
why. 7-Eleven's bestseller that never sold, so they discontinued, you know?
I ate so many bags of those.
I did too. I think the only people buying them were people who worked there.
Yeah, because they're good.
Yeah. You'd occasionally be like, oh, I've got a whole wall of them. And you'd be like, hey, regular customer.
Yeah.
Eat these hot dog chips. They're fire.
Yeah. But I would tell people about them all the time.
Yeah. I'd sell bags that way, but nobody ever like came in on a regular basis to buy hot dog chips.
So these are extra bold mustard and ketchup flavored sandwich chips.
Let's start with ketchup.
I figured that's where you'd
I don't like ketchup. I don't like ketchup chips.
I know you hate ketchup. God, these bags are quality.
The bold mustard kind of makes me excited.
It's like a... Ooh, wait. It's like a ketchup mustard. Or a ketchup relish.
Ooh, that actually... You're right. There's a relish smell. And that gives me a little bit of hope as long as they don't taste so tomato-y. All
right. I'm going for that one.
These are definitely Herr's interpretation of Ruffles.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they all have their own ridges.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's just ridges.
Yeah. Cheers. Right,
cheers.
That's not bad.
No, it's not. It's not tomato-y. I feel like these ketchup chip flavors really lean into, like, sweet tomato. Mm-hmm. You're like...
They lean into the Heinz ketchup. As opposed to, like, a nice vinegary ketchup.
Which is probably why I hate ketchup. Because I just don't ever get the vinegary kind. It's...
Go for catsup.
Yeah, okay.
That's the vinegary kind.
I don't even wrong. Like, I don't love this.
The crisp is good. It's a good chip.
Like on a sandwich?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It could be absolute fire.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
It's subtle. It's not overwhelming. It's good. It's what I want from ketchup. I'm excited about these now.
I'll let you smell because they actually smell really good.
Mm, it's like that. It's the sweet, spicy mustard.
Mm-hmm. Well, they are extra bold. Going for that one right there.
I love mustard. I love, like, a spicy mustard. Stadium mustard, which is apparently a Cleveland thing. Love it.
It's delicious.
Yeah. I don't know why that's a Cleveland thing. Also,
I think it's a play on like a German, like seeded mustard kind of thing.
Yeah.
Like Bavarian mustard.
You can get it other places, but like we call it stadium mustard and other places don't really call it that. Like,
what do they call it?
It's like gold mustard. Like they call it golden.
Oh, I know what they're talking about. There's actually a brand that is gold and mustard. That makes sense.
Which is, and that's what the most similar thing in other regions are. But in Ohio, we get like literally
stadium mustard. And I think it's because it's ground a little bit finer. So the stadium mustard, if I remember correctly, it's just a darker flavor, but it's smooth.
Yeah.
The brown has like little specks in it.
Yeah, because it's not really like a Dijon mustard.
No.
Or it's its own kind of thing. Anyway.
It is its own thing. Well, cheers.
Cheers.
That's good.
That's real good. You know how the spicy Dorito mustard were too like zippy and too weird? But they kind of, you couldn't just eat them. These are different. Yeah, I know. These are perfect on their own. They're exactly the right level of subtlety.
Yeah.
They're enjoyable to eat on their own. And I think that's the real kicker. That's the point that you hit. Those are great. Mm-hmm. I love those.
Yeah, the mustard chips are really
good. I want more of those.
Get them over to Ollie's.
Ollie's.
They're like $1.09.
Definitely going to Ollie's just to get mustard chips. Anyway. It's great. If you like mustard, you'll love those.
Oh, yeah,
I
those
think
are delicious.
Also on a sandwich, perfect.
Oh, absolutely. Like a nice bologna and... Like,
oh, my God. On a bologna sandwich?
Uh-huh.
All right. I'm going for a combo.
Mm-hmm. You'll like it. It subtles. It tones down the sweetness.
You can put both on a sandwich.
Yeah. Just do them both at the same time. Put them on a burger. You don't have to put, like, mustard and ketchup on. Just those two and you're done.
I put nice. The other thing is, like, I don't love, like, a big hot dog covered in sauce. Like, as much as I like a mustard on a hot dog, if you put too much of it on it, it ruins the hot dog for me.
Yeah, of course.
I put the spicy Doritos, the mustard Doritos on a hot dog. It's, like, perfect. And, like, if you put these on it, both of these on a hot dog, I'd be like, yeah, hell
yeah. Because it gives it that crunch it really needs.
Mm-hmm. And it doesn't, like, drown it into goo.
What's your feeling about footlong hot dogs?
That they sound fantastic,
but they're always
They're never very good.
Yeah. I like a good plain hot dog every now and then.
They're all beef. footlongs, they'd be good.
No, they never.
I need an all beef Costco footlong.
Costco hot dogs are almost a footlong.
They're pretty much. They're probably like 9 inches long, if nothing else. Yeah, but these are tasty. I dig these mustard chips.
Be really good on a Costco hot dog.
Oh yeah, we try new things almost every single day, so you don't have to. So hit like, leave us a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe.
Play us out, Adam.
It's the Snack Network. It's the Snack Network. Oh, I tried, and I tried to find something that I could rhyme with the Snack Network.
But there's literally nothing. There's not a f***ing thing that you can rhyme with it.